Newton, he has some pretty big openers. We're going to see her later. Almost ready to start the women's 45 kilo category. Athletes are warming up backstage. You can see the clock now, just over 3.5 minutes to go. For those of you who are new to the sport of powerlifting, athletes will compete head-to-head in the bench press discipline. This is going to be quite simply a test of upper body strength. Who can lift the heaviest? That's how the medals are going to be determined. If two lifters lift the same, then the lighter athlete will win. Athletes only receive 3 attempts, and it's their top weight that counts. There's the discs we're going to be using. 50 kilos for the black ones. Reds are 25, blues are 20. Yellows 15 kilos, and the green ones will be 10. The bench is slightly different in powerlifting, slightly wider. So there'll be straps available to anchor the legs to the bench. This helps the athlete to make sure that the hips and the feet don't come out of contact. And here we are backstage. Picture there, we've got Latifat Tajani of Nigeria. She's an athlete of some caliber. Haven't seen a huge amount of her in the past. And there's your Chinese contingent, Hu Dandan. She has the heaviest weights posted, 100 kilos is the weight that she is set to come out on. So these athletes now will be putting the final preparations to their warm-up. They time their warm-up so that as they're called to the platform, they've finished just a few minutes before. Most of these lifters won't bother taking any additional warm-up attempts between rounds. So unlike Olympic weightlifting, where it's a rising bar, it is a rising bar here, but it's done in a round robin system. So all athletes will take one attempt and then we move on to round two. The order of the athletes will be determined by the lightest coming out first, finishing with the heaviest. Well, here's the world record, which is held by the lady we've just seen from China, Hu Dandan. Huge, 106 kilos. To give you an idea, the Paralympic standard is 97 kilos. So any athletes get up to those kind of weights, we're going to see records galore. Just to give you an idea, 3 athletes are down to start heavier than the Olympic standard. Here's the jury. Ladies and gentlemen, that can overturn any decisions from referees. Today's lineup, as we've said, Hu Dandan from China makes her Paralympic debut, but is the 2014 Asian Para Games champion. Zoe Newson of Great Britain, bronze medalist from London, the 2012 Paralympic Games, looking to go better here in Rio. She's been strong in training and could well be a medal threat. Gabrielle Ferrero of Mexico competing in her 5th Paralympic Games. Let's not forget Jozdyk of Poland, Justyna, who knows what it takes to win Paralympic medals. She's a world medalist too, so we've got a great field ahead, great caliber of lifters. Here's the countdown now to the start of the competition.
Lowers, please lower the bar to 75 kilograms, rack height 7.
Andeiros, por favor, montar a barra com 75 quilos e a altura do rack 7.
Thank you. The bar is loaded to 75 kilos.
So we can hear the bar has been loaded, 75 kilos. This is the nominated weight from the Mexican contingent. Laura Ferrero will be the first lifter to the platform. 2 minutes from when the bar is loaded and the athlete has been called. Slightly different to Olympic weightlifting, where the athletes receive 1 minute, unless they're following themselves. In this case, it's 2 minutes, and 3 minutes if you're following yourself. So the athletes will come on to the platform from the left-hand side and will exit on the right-hand side. It's the coach that generally assists their athletes into position. So Ferrero, competing in her fifth Paralympic Games. She's won bronze medals in Sydney, Athens and Beijing. Twice been a world silver medalist and twice a world bronze medalist. Never taken top spot. Can she get herself onto the podium here in Rio at the age of 49 years? So we have three spotters in the yellow t-shirts. The centre spotter can assist the lifter to take the bar off the racks into the start position. He'll then make a quick exit and allow the central referee a good view of the lift. The two side spotters will link their hands underneath the bar and just track the bar down and up for safety. Okay, so I think the centre referee was half asleep there, forgot to give the re-rack command. She won't make that mistake again. Lifter has not been penalised for that mistake by the referee. 2-1 decision, it's a good lift. She's got three referees, all in the blue jackets. Centre referee, maybe you can see on the chair, in the centre of the frame. So the rules are, the bar must be lowered under control to the chest. Just pause momentarily on the chest without sinking into the rib cage, and then driven back to arm's length. But the key thing to look out for is that the bar remains absolutely level. Any tipping of that bar, and that's when we're going to see red lights from the referees. So here are the body weights. Lightest athlete, in fact, Tijani of Nigeria. No, I apologise. Mario of Nigeria, weighing at 43.33. That may come into place if two lifters lift the same. Weighing would have taken place a couple of hours before the competition got underway. So next up, Samira Guerrero of Algeria. As mentioned, she is the lightest lifter in the category, age 32. We have limited information about Samira. Personal best of 80 kilos, which was set at the World Championships in 2014, where she placed eighth. Just asking her coach to wake up. Come on, give me the straps, I'm ready to go. Some of the athletes prefer the coaches to do the work. Some prefer to do it themselves. So the clock is approaching 1 minute, still plenty of time. Bar. Your hands are not allowed to go any wider than those rings. They can go up to, over. The centre referee must not be able to see the rings inside the hands. Well, looks good, but I'm no referee, so let's wait to see if the referees agree. Yes, they do. 2-1 decision again. Cheeky tongue out. Relief, I don't know. It's always nice to secure the first lift in the competition. You know you can get a result then. Three attempts, you've got to have one of them register as good. Lovely control on the way down. Touches the chest, pauses, and then drives back to arm's length. Well, when I say this bar needs to remain absolutely level, to a point where you can put a spirit level on the bar. That's how strict the refereeing will be. And that's why we will see a lot of split decisions from the referees.
Thank you. Bar floated to 90 kilograms for first attempt from Ukraine, Lesa Doporkova.
So bar is now going up again. We're looking at 90 kilos in weight.
Lifter to follow, Otefi, Egypt.
This is going to be the opening attempt for Reyesa Toparkova, 30 years of age. Reyesa has demonstrated great improvements to win the 2014 World Championship title. 96 kilos was the weight lifted there. She's coming out here on a 90, so starting just below best. Body weight of sub 45 kilos. We're now hitting double body weight mark. This is pretty impressive by anybody's standards. Oh, it's slow. It looked to me like her left arm, the right of the pitcher, that arm went up quicker than the other. And the referees saw that as well. That looked tough for a first attempt. Doesn't matter the speed that the bar comes back up. It doesn't even matter if it pauses momentarily on the way up, so long as it doesn't come back down. It came up smoothly. My technical term here is wonky. There we go, that's where the tip of the bar happened, and that's cost her her first attempt. It's going to limit how far she is able to progress in this competition. Barkova needs to have that discussion with the coach now. Then she's sure that we will see her coming out on the same weight again. So first attempt now for Zainab Otefi of Egypt. Bronze medalist from the Beijing 2008 Paralympic Games, where she placed, and then she placed fourth in London. So, two Paralympic Games under her belt. This is her third. Personal best of 97.5 kilos. That was set back in 2010. So, it's been a while since she's been at that kind of standard. Can she get herself back onto the podium here in Rio? Originally posted just 85 kilos as her opening attempt, but athletes are allowed to change that within 5 minutes of the event starting, and she has. She's upped it to 90. So, double body weight attempt.
1 minute.
Slightly unorthodox style, chooses not to use any strapping on the legs. Going for a fairly close grip as well, by the looks of it. She was just playing. Most lifters will take a nice wide grip. Simple reason is it's less distance for the bar to travel. Doesn't need help. Now, was that nice and level on the way up? We'll have to wait and see. Well, she's got it. Maybe a little lucky there. 2-1, she's not happy with it. She knows that she needs to make the next one better. Rules are that the head, the shoulders, the hips, and the feet must stay in contact with the bench. From now, so when the lift starts.
Por favor, montar a barra com 95 kg e rack altura 3.
see here the position of the back makes the chest nice and high. It's the best distance for the bar to travel. Watch the hips. Need to stay in contact with the bench, and they do.
The bar is loaded. Thank you for the first attempt. From Poland, Justyna Kozlowicz, 95 kilograms.
Barra montada com 95 quilos para a primeira tentativa de Justyna Kozlowicz.
So, first attempt for Justyna Kozdryk, Poland. She's opted for 95 kilos as her first attempt. No messing around, straight onto the bench. Despite lifting more in the London Paralympic Games, 95 kilos, she placed fifth, having won a silver in Beijing with 92.5. How gutting is that? Well, super strong, very aggressive on the drive back to arm's length. Nice, clean lifting. It's one of the first lifts we've seen. Three white lights and the cheeky smile as if to say, yeah, I got this. And it's great to see the athletes enjoying the experience as well. A lot of pressure now. Justyna Kozdryk of Poland is safely in the competition.
It would be a new Paralympic record. Thank you. The bar is loaded.
We're now moving to the top end of the competition. We're about to see first attempt from Great Britain's Zoe Newson, bronze medalist 4 years ago, looking to go better here in Rio. I was speaking to her coach only a couple of months ago at the British Championships. Said she's been training really well. It looks good to break any previous best. She lifted 88 kilos in London, but here coming out on 98. So clearly preparation has been going really well. Heard that in training she's lifted up to about 105 kilos. So let's hope she can get somewhere close to that today. Zoe Newson, first attempt, 98. Well, how strong does that look? Great lifting, three white lights from the referees. That's a great start. You can see here, bar goes down, pauses, smashes it back to arm's length. So he was actually banned from competing in 2014 Commonwealth Games in Glasgow, Scotland, due to being declassified as a result of a change to the powerlifting governing body in terms of how they measured legitimate lifts. However, the rules were changed once again, resulting in her being reclassified and making an international return last year.
For the first attempt from Nigeria, Latifat Tijani.
Barra montada, 101 kilos para primeira tentativa. Tijani, da Nigeria.
So, coming onto the stage now for her first attempt is Nigeria's Latifat Tijani, first attempt now with 101 kilos. She posted 98 at the weigh-in, but preparation has clearly gone well. Before the first lift of this competition, she chose to increase her starting weight. Now, due to some of the athletes' impairments, affects the positions that they can get their legs into. The rules specify that the feet must be in contact with the bench, whether that's legs straight, legs bent, it doesn't matter. You can see here the use of the strap just to ensure that they stay fixed to the bench. Big arch of the back makes the chest nice and high. 101 kilos. Well, there's a new Paralympic Games record. She's just taken it away from Zoe Newson of Great Britain. Every lift that we're going to see, top end, looks like it could be breaking records. We still are yet to see the Chinese lifter come in. But Nigeria's Latifat Tijani, 101 kilos.
Loaders, please load the bar to 102 kilos. Rack height, 7.
Pedileiros, por favor, montar a
great lifting.
102 kilos, altura do rack, 7.
Once again, if successful, this would be a new Paralympic record.
So, last lifter in round one.
Hu
Dandan of China.
For the first attempt,
just going through
the
motions in her head.
Hu Dandan.
Waiting in the wings.
Atleta da China, Hu Dandan. Se ela realizar o movimento, será mais uma quebra de recorde paralímpico da categoria.
Well, gold medalist from the 2014 Asian Para Games. Personal best at competition level in world competition, only 99 kilos. Coming out here on a 102, so clearly wants to smash that 100 kilo milestone. If successful, this will be another Paralympic Games record. Just 4 kilos shy of our own world record, which stands at 106. She's able to get a huge arch in the back. So long as the head, the shoulders, hips and feet remain in contact with the bench, that's okay. But lifting the back into that position just makes it easier. Bar doesn't have to travel as far. Well, extremely strong. Let's see what the referees make of it. And it's been given 2-1. Thought that level of the bar maybe slightly out. I think that's what the centre referee would have seen. The other two referees are from the side, so they don't get the fresh head-on view that the centre referee will get. It's a little wonky to me, a little low on our left side of the screen, but that's irrelevant. She's been given it, and there's a new Paralympic Games record, 102 kilos, tremendous lifting, tremendous demonstration of upper body strength.
Thank you. The bar is loaded to 80 kilos.
So only two athletes from the first round that are yet to register a good lift. Everybody else is safely in the competition. So, round two.
Algeria.
Again, the order is determined by a rising bar. We are back to Laura Ferrero of Mexico, the 49-year-old. When asked why she got into the sport of powerlifting, she said, "In the beginning, I was told this was a sport for men only. But I believed women are also capable of doing whatever the men could. When I saw other women competitors, I wanted to be as strong as them." Well, there's not many people in the world that are stronger than this lady. Her impairment is a result of the effects of polio developed at the age of 10 months old. So having missed her opening attempt with 75 kilos, has now opted for 80. Is this risky? We'll wait and see. bar's not moving. Centre referee asks for the bar to be re-racked. And that's when the side spotters step in. So this could be a costly mistake. Missed the 75 on the first attempt. Chose to increase to 80, unable to drive the bar back to arm's length. Now on the third attempt, she needs to get a result. This didn't look overly convincing. Simply not strong enough today. Let's hope she can recompose in time for her third and final attempt. So as you can see, centre referee will give the start signal. And when they are happy that either the lift is finished or, as you just saw, there's a problem, they will ask for the bar to be re-racked. Loader's just giving the bench a wipe down, just for hygiene reasons. You can see them adjusting the racks. Each lifter chooses how high or how low they wish to have the racks, and that's obviously based on their length of their arms.
Thank you. The bar is low to 88 kilograms. Second attempt from Algeria, Samira Gadiola.
Barra pronta com 88 quilos para a segunda tentativa de Samira Gadiola, Argentina.
So the Algerian lifter coming up onto the stage for her second attempt, Samira Guerreiroa, 32-year-old. Previous best of 80 kilos. She's coming out here for a second attempt on 88. Clearly coming into these Paralympic Games in great form. If you're going to set personal bests, this is the place to do it. Not allowed to strap over the knees. Strap above or below. Strapping is not allowed to cross the hip joint or the knee joint. It's not compulsory, you don't have to use it. Most do, to help keep the legs in contact with the bench. So 88 kilos, second attempt. Well, looks strong to me. Samira Guerreiroa just has to wait a split second for the decision. Oh, and it's been failed. Well, how close can you get? Just asking the coach what was wrong with it. It's a shame. To be a weight that's right up to a limit. A little bit of sinking into the chest, maybe didn't pause for quite long enough. Appeared to come down, touch the chest and go straight back up. The level of the bar looked good. You'll know how challenging this is for those of you that bench back home. Just going to change it slightly so you go down a bit more controlled. You have to pause without any compression in the chest cavity. Keep the bar dead level on the way up. Try doing that on the first best. Here's your current standings. Hu Dandan takes the lead at the moment after round one with 102 kilos. We have the Nigerian athlete in second place with 101. And in third place at the moment, Great Britain's Zoe Newson. Let's see if they can stay in those positions after the second round. Or are we going to see any changes? So third attempt now for Ukrainians, Raisa Topakova. Her philosophy, beating yourself is sometimes much harder than beating the strongest of opponents. Well, this is going to be needed if she wants a chance of a podium finish. She's going to have to beat anything she's ever done before. Get close to the personal best of 96 kilos, which is set back in 2014. Well, it looked more level than the first attempt, but the referees have still seen an infringement.
Movimento nulo na segunda tentativa de Toporkova na mulher.
Now she's looking puzzled, asking the coach, come on, what was wrong with that?
92 kilograms.
She can see from this
angle.
Well, yeah, it did come up slightly uneven. Her left arm started to press before the right almost. Only marginal, but that's how strict the refereeing is. Unfortunately, that's 2 out of 2 failures with 90 kilos. She's going to have to execute on a third and final attempt to stay in the competition. This is not the kind of day she had planned. So, Zeynep Otaefi of Egypt. She's closing her eyes on the ride up the ramp. Preparation is just as important as the physical. You've got to believe in your ability, believe that you're capable of these weights. Kilos being loaded onto the bar. She's back up where she's been at the previous 2 Paralympic Games. Best ever, 95 kilos. Doesn't look very level to me. I think we're going to see a no lift here.
No lift.
It's a shame. Strong enough to get the bar back to arm's length, but that's not just what this competition is about. Para powerlifting has very strict rules that need to be adhered to. Lifters know what those rules are. They train for them, but it's a different ball game when you're on this kind of platform under this kind of pressure. Fortunately, this lift of 92 kilos is not going to count. There, we just see one arm moving faster than the other. It does seem harsh when the bar goes back to arm's length, but the rules are the rules. She knows what she has to do on her final attempt. So, up to the business end of proceedings now. This is where the medals are likely to be decided. Poland's Justyna Kostryk has chosen 98 kilos, a very sensible call from her coaches. If successful, this will put her up into the bronze medal position ahead of Zoe Newsom by virtue of lighter body weight. Three-time world silver medalist. She wants a place on the podium here in Rio. That level, let's see what the referees think. And they failed it. She knows why. Wow, so frustrating. So much focus required, so much discipline to keep that bar in exactly the right position, but that could be a costly mistake. That would have put her up into the medals and put some pressure on Zoe Newson. It's not to be. Zoe will be the next lifter out.
Thank you. The bar is loaded at 102 kilograms. For the second attempt from Great Britain, Zoe Newson.
So, Zoe Newson coming up now to extend her lead in the bronze medal position. In fact, this was going to take her into the silver medal position. Whether it's going to be good enough to keep her there, only time will tell. But this, for the lead, for another big effort from Zoe. She's been training for about 10 years now, works in a children's nursery back home. Big fan of Arsenal Football Club. Right now, she's got her mind focused on one thing and one thing only. It's progressing up the ranks. This for second place. Well, looks very, very strong. And it's been given, yes, 2-1. Zoe moves up into the silver medal position, equals the Paralympic Games record. Great lifting, nice control. Manages to keep the head and the shoulders on the bench. Doesn't have a great elbow lockout. That was a controversy surrounding not being able to compete at the Commonwealth Games. Aaron Singh in picture, coaching her.
Thank you.
Chat with Aaron the other day. We knew Zoe was good shape coming into this competition. She now can only sit back and watch and see if the Nigerian and Chinese lifters push further ahead. So, up onto the platform for her second attempt. Nigeria's Latifat Tijani.
People's Republic of China.
Needs this now. And if successful, would put her up into the lead ahead of Hao Dandan of China. This for an attempt at a new Paralympic Games record. Just 2 kilos short of the current world record. Looks north, asking for some assistance from above. Asking for help now from the centre loader. His hand to get the bar off the racks. Just adjusting into position, making the chest as high as possible. Does that look straight to you? What do the referees make of it? No lift. That's because the bar was slightly wonky on the way up. Oh, and there's a look of disappointment. That would have been enough to move into the lead and put the pressure on China. Not to be. Still has one attempt remaining. See, fairly commonly with the Nigerian lifters, they opt to have the hands slightly closer than most athletes. Most of the lifters will take the hands right out to the marks on the bar, making full use of the width available. With the hands closer, as we can see here, it just means that bar has to travel a bit further.
Thank you. The bar is loaded to 105 kilograms. For the second attempt from the People's Republic of China.
So here we go. Here's your leader after round one. She's still going to be the leader after round two, but the question is, can she extend that lead? Can she extend the Paralympic Games record? 105 kilos is the weight that has been requested. Competed in wheelchair tennis in the 2008 Paralympic Games before switching to powerlifting. Impairment, the results, the effects of polio. Nothing standing in her way right now. She's ready to go. Can she extend the lead even further? Oh, there it is. There's the celebration. 2-1 majority. Great lifting. Another Paralympic Games record. Finishes the round in the lead, only just though, ahead of Great Britain's Zoe Newson. She needed this lift. Executed superbly. A slight change at the top of the leaderboard after the second round. It's the same three that are in the medal positions. Brilliant lifting. What are we going to see on a third and final attempt? Lifters have two opportunities now to change their weight instead of one. Remember, the world record is 106. So here we are. Current standings in the women's 45 kilo category. Hu Dandan is in the lead, 105. Zoe Newson in second place, 102, and in third place, unable to progress in the third round, is Nigeria's Latifat Tijanani, sat back on 101. So round three in the women's 45 kilo category, live from Rio Centro Pavilion 2. Day two of the Paralympic Games here in Rio. We have Laura Ferrero of Mexico. Third and final attempt, 88 kilos, under some serious pressure right now. Missed 75. Then, for some reason, went up to 80. Unable to get it off the chest. Third and final attempt. Needs this to stay in the competition. I don't think that's going up. Centre referee has called for the bar to be re-racked. Stop on the way up. As soon as it started tipping, it was game over. Unfortunately, three successive failures. We'll see Laura Ferrero of Mexico out of the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. What a shame, what a disappointment. Hopefully a learning curve she can build on going forward. The age of 49, let's hope we do see her back for a sixth Paralympic Games, maybe. Having competed already at five Paralympic Games, that really is a remarkable achievement in itself. She should be commended for her efforts and services to the sport.
Thank you. The bar is lowered to 88 kilograms. For the third attempt, from Algeria, Samira Gariowa.
So, third and final attempt now for Algeria's Samira Gariowa. Successful with 85 on a first attempt. Failed with 88 on a second. Same weight remains on the bar. Successful. This will put her into sixth place. Is that straight? I'm not sure. I think the left side of the bar came up slightly quicker. And it's been failed. That's gutting. She did everything she could.
Voters, 90 kilograms, please.
Shows how much discipline is required in this event. Cannot afford to have one arm stronger than the other. Afford to lose focus for a split second. It's got to be absolutely spot on to pass. Doesn't matter if the bar clips the racks on the way up, so long as it's not advantageous to the third butt. Referees are not happy with how straight the bar was. Well, she'll finish back with 80 kilos. Raisa Toporkova of the Ukraine, the 30-year-old, is now under pressure in her third Paralympic Games. Missed 90 twice, not been overly convincing. Well, she has a battle now with herself, a battle with the bar. Third and final attempt, 90 kilos to get a result here at the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. Come on. Successful, this would put her up into fifth place. She would go ahead of the Egyptian lifter by virtue of lighter body weight, but needs to execute here. Well, it was a much more aggressive attempt, wasn't it? What do the referees think? No, oh, does she know it? Just wait anxiously for the decision. Well, how frustrating. Three successive failures at 90 kilos. She's out of the competition. See if we can see what happened. Down under control. Pause. Must have been, yeah, there we are, one side coming up slightly faster than the other. What a shame. That's Costa placing here in Rio.
Thank you. The bar is loaded to 92 kilograms for the third attempt from Egypt, Zainab Otefi.
Barra pronta com 92 quilos para a terceira tentativa de Zainab Otefi, do Egito.
Lifter to follow. Kozdrick, Poland.
Prepara Kozdrick, da Polônia.
So, third attempt now for Egypt's Zainab Otefi. 38-year-old, endeavouring to put another 2 kilos on an attempt from the first round. Successful with 90, then failed with 92. Third and final attempt. Said that. Come on, you've got this. Well, she does like to take the time to prepare and go through the ritual each time. 30 seconds on the clock now. She'll be aware of how long she has. Her coach will give those instructions. Oh, I don't think so. Well, that's a shame. It's not there today. Have to be happy and content with the 90 she succeeded with on a first attempt.
Loaders, please load the bar to 101 kilograms. Rack height is 3.
Cadeiros, por favor, montar a barra com 101 quilos. Suporte 3.
Was never going anywhere, was it? Right arm just stopped pushing. It's really a great setup here. The athletes have everything they need. Plenty of platforms, plenty of benches available.
Thank you. The bar is loaded.
So here we go. Back to the business end.
From Poland, Justyna Kozdrick.
Justyna Kozdrick, third and final attempt, successful in 95, missed 98, has had no choice but to go up to 101. If successful, this would put her into the bronze medal position ahead of Nigeria's Latifat Tajani by virtue of lighter body weight. So we could see potentially the Nigerian lifter under some pressure. But this, to have a chance of getting onto the podium. Works as a civil servant in the traffic department, the district police in Poland. Here she's got one mission, 101. Is she strong? Can she nail? No, not to be. Well, she took the weight that was necessary. Cannot have any regrets. She gave it a go. Quite simply, not strong enough on the day. You don't try, you don't know. Well, would that have passed anyway with it sinking into the chest? I'm not sure. Got to the sticking point and got stuck. So, Justyna Kozdrick of Poland, 36-year-old. She's left down the rankings slightly, fourth place. Worst place you can finish.
Thank you. The bar is
disappointment and frustration, but at the same time, she gave it a go. So,
from Great Britain, Zoe Newson.
We've got some athletes gambling now. There's been a change in terms of the order that these lifters have been called. Zoe Newson, who is the second place after the second round, is coming up for her third attempt, just showing elbows to the referees, reminding them that they don't lock out properly. She's been in great shape in training. I was told by her coaches that she has done 105 in training. That's the weight she's now opted for on her third attempt. If successful, this would put her up into the gold medal position. This would equal the Paralympic Games record, which has just been set a few moments ago by Chinese lifter. Here we go, third attempt, Zoe Newson. Well, what do the referees think? Oh, it's not there. 2-1 against. What a shame. She has to sit and wait now and see what the other two lifters are capable of.
Please load the bar to 106 kilograms. Rack height, 12.
Oh, the only thing I can see there is the arms weren't as straight as they were at the start. And no, her elbows don't fully extend. I do think it was a bit short to finish at the top.
First place, as well as a new Paralympic record.
So, just got to sit and wait now. Zoe currently in silver medal position. Guaranteed a medal though. Congratulations, Zoe. Two lifters now remaining in this competition. And we're going to see more records. Third attempt now for Nigeria's Latifat Tijani, coming out on 106. She doesn't need this weight. 105 would have been sufficient to put her up into the lead. She is lighter than Hu Dandan of China, which was forcing Zoe out for her attempt. So 106, an attempt now at the Paralympic Games record.
If
successful, this will put her up into the lead. If she fails, she'll stay down in bronze medal position. Well, it went to arm's length. What do the referees think? Was it level? Well, she's been given it. 2-1. There's your current leader. She's your Paralympic Games record holder. Question is, can she stay there? That pushes Zoe down into the bronze medal position. Nicely under control. Pauses on the chest. Drives back to arm's length. The referees were happy.
Your
current leader, is she going to stay in that gold medal position?
Thank
only
you.
One
the
person
to
deny her
kilograms.
Top spot on the podium.
From China, Hu Dandan.
Oh, this is an anxious wait. There's nothing she can do. Sit and wait. Well, the pressure now is back on Hu Dandan. From China, the 27-year-old making a Paralympic debut. What a debut she's making.
If successful, this would be a new Paralympic record.
So here we go, big lift, Paralympic record attempt, also a world record attempt. It's her own world record. More importantly, this for the gold medal. So this is the lift she's come for. This is the medal that she wants. Successful, gold, records galore. Misses it. She'll have to be content with the silver. Well, it's gone to arm's length. What's the decision? She's got it. There's your gold medalist. There's your Paralympic Games champion in the women's 45 kilo category here in Rio Centro Pavilion 2. What a truly remarkable effort. Well, there's your gold medalist. There's your champion. I'm not sure that that is the end of the competition, though. Well, the medals have been decided. There are rules as well that specify if you're within 10 kilos of a world record, you can have a fourth attempt. The results won't count in any competition. You could see one or two further lifts to try and push this amazing 107 kilo world record even further.
Andreiros, por favor, montar a barra com 107 quilos. Hack 4.
Well, well done to Hu Dandan. People's Republic of China.
The bar is loaded to 107 kilograms for the fourth attempt of Great Britain's Zoe Newson.
So, looks like we are going to see a fourth attempt. Zoe Newson fancies her chances from Great Britain.
Loaders, another half kilo, please. 107.
So 107.5 is the weight that has been requested.
The athlete is still Zoe Newson. 107.5, rack height 4.
Brasileiros, por favor, montar a barra com 107.5 quilos. Rack 4.
So the medals have been decided. Zoe is the bronze medalist. But because her previous attempt was close enough to the world record, she has permitted a fourth attempt. She won't progress through the ranks any further. She was unable to do it in the first three rounds. But it is an attempt at a world record. And obviously, does it count as a Paralympic Games record? I'm not sure. 107.5, though, definite world record attempt. Querying stands as a games record is because the first three rounds are the only rounds to count. Well, this will be amazing if she gets it, but gutting at the same time as she's left down in bronze medal position. Come on then, Zoe. Let's see what you've got. Oh, I don't think so. I don't think that went anywhere near arm's length. It was a good effort, though.
No lift for Newson.
Well, Zoe will have to wait for another day to have another pop at that record. But again, is that the end of the competition? Hu Dandan has asked for 108. Good attempt, Zoe. Not quite to be today. Congratulations on a bronze medal, though.
Well done. Well done. High five.
Well, there's the tears. There's the smiles. Hasn't she started Team GB's campaign off really, really well?
Thank you. The bar is loaded to 108 kilograms for the fourth attempt from the People's Republic of China.
So we are going to see Hu Dandan coming out for a fourth attempt. 108 now is the weight that has been requested.
If successful, this fourth attempt will set a world record and a new Paralympic record.
Se conseguir realizar o movimento, quebrará novamente seu próprio recorde paralímpico e mundial da categoria.
So again, this doesn't stand in the competition. A new world record attempt. 108 kilos for Hu Dandan of China. This to break her own world record that she set just a few minutes previously. So here we go. World record attempt, 108 kilos, Hu Dandan of China. Oh, that looks good. Do the referees agree? Split second of anxious waiting. Yes, they do. There she is.
A new world
Another world record. Does stand as a Paralympic Games record as well. Tremendous lifting from China's Hu Dandan. What more can you ask for? Records all the way through. Pretty much every lift attempted was a new record. And here she is finishing with a big one, 108. Tremendous lifting, and just put this in perspective, at sub 45 kilo body weight, well in excess of double body weight. Huge congratulations to the Chinese athlete.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain in your seats for the upcoming victory ceremony of the women's up to 45 kilo competition. Thank you.
Senhoras e senhores, por favor, permaneçam em seus lugares para a cerimônia de premiação da categoria feminina de até 45 quilos. Obrigado.
And here are your current standings in the women's 45 kilo category here at the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. Your champion, Hu Dandan of China, with a massive world record, 107, it's actually 108 is the weight she's just done, but 107 is the weight that counts in the competition. Second place, Nigeria's Latifat Tijani, 106 kilos, and in bronze medal position, Great Britain's Zoe Newson with a huge 102 kilos, attempted a world record, not quite there, finishing just outside the medals. Polish lifter, Krozdryk. But top three, very decisive, very clearly those most deserving of a podium place.
tickets to future sessions should visit the ticket box offices or go online on www.rio2016.com/tickets.
Ingressos para todos os outros eventos estão à venda em nossas bilheterias ou pelo site www.rio2016.com/ingressos.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for powerlifting, women's up to 45 kilogram competition.
Senhoras e senhores, a cerimônia de premiação do halterofilismo da categoria feminina até 45 quilos.
The victory ceremony of the women's 45 kilo category here, Rio Centro Pavilion 2, Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. This is the moment that these athletes have dreamt of, have trained for, day after day, month after month, year after year, and you can see just how much it means. Zoe, not ashamed to wipe the tears away. Pretty special moment to be awarded a medal at such a magnificent event.
The medals will be presented by Chairperson of Sports Technical Committee of International Powerlifting.
John Amos.
Powerlifting.
As medalhas serão entregues pelo presidente do comitê
representative here.
De halterofilismo do
Paralympic
IBC,
Games.
John Amos.
Done so much for the sport back home.
Procurement Director of Rio 2016.
Acompanhado pelo diretor de suprimentos da Rio 2016, o senhor João Saraiva.
So, medals to be presented by João Saraiva. John Amos.
Medalha de bronze representando.
So he's ready to go. Wants to jump onto
Zoe
that podium.
Houston.
Huge congratulations. Thoroughly deserved. She's 98 on a first attempt. 10 kilos more than she finished the London Paralympic Games with. 102 on a second attempt. Huge 105 attempt, just missed it, then had a go at the world record 107.5. Not to be, you have to be content. Bronze, she was in London. Silver medalist representing Nigeria, Latifat Tijani. Well, she had a good go, put herself into contention. She had one small mistake on her second attempt with 104, missed it. Took the gamble and went to 106. Put her up into the lead temporarily. Quite simply, was beaten by a better lifter on the day. Some things you have to live with. And hopefully we will see her back in 4 years' time, stronger, pushing the records even further. Hope those are tears of happiness. They should be.
And Paralympic champion representing
have your heart set.
Only
one medal. It's tough to accept anything else.
Fica representando a República Popular da China. Hu
Dandan.
Hu Dandan of China takes your gold medal. Doesn't she deserve it? Flawless run through today. 102, 105. 107, all Paralympic Games records. 107 was a world record. She then had a fourth attempt at 108. Nailed that as well. What a day in the office. There is your Paralympic champion in the women's 45 kilo category.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of People's Republic of China.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da República Popular da China.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, the Paralympic medalists.
Senhoras e senhores, as medalhistas paralímpicas.
Well, now they can relax, now they can enjoy the moment. Some formalities to go through. Photo opportunities, the interviews, they will be aplenty. Zoe clearly enjoying her moment on the podium, so is Hu Dandan. And here is Latifat Majani, she's back, disappearing back off, back to the training room, she wants the gold medal next time. Tremendous effort from all three athletes, should be commended for their accolades here today.
Ao deixar seu assento, por favor, leve seu lixo para ser depositado nas lixeiras espalhadas do pavilhão 2 do Rio Centro. Obrigado.
Assist us by leaving the venue as quickly as possible. Spectators are waiting to enter for the next session. Thank you.
Well, we've seen some huge weights lifted, well in excess of double body weight in the women's 45 kilo category. I hope you've enjoyed the records galore that we have been spoilt with. This concludes the women's 45 kilo category from Rio Centro Pavilion 2, the Rio 2016 Olympic Games. Bye from me.